calm. It's the Super G. It's your first race. And whatever you do, it's going to be fine. I was a little bit nervous at the beginning, and you get a little bit more nervous because it is the first race. So for me, it was a surprise. If you look coldly at the summer you've spent, the preparation you've had, well, it wasn't very much, you could say. So just to be here at all is not bad. At the Winter University Games, Marc Oliveras was trying to make history by winning a medal for the tiny Pyrenean Principality of Andorra. But it was something of a miracle that he was able to take part at all after what happened to him last summer. I didn't feel good. I felt wrong. I felt very wrong in the hands and the feet. I woke up in the morning with a really high pulse and I told myself, this isn't normal. What's happening here? It's bizarre. And I also had marks on my skin. So I went to have some tests taken by the Federation's doctor. And finally, the analyses came through and they came out positive for lupus, an autoimmune disease. And yeah, it's been hard, a little bit hard. Lupus can attack the victim's vital organs, and one of Mark's kidneys has been affected. It was completely unexpected. I was with the doctor, and I didn't know what it was. At the beginning, they told me, the sun mustn't touch you. And that's when you say to yourself, how am I going to cope? You start to ask questions, all that sort of thing. At the beginning, it was a very sudden change, and for me, it was a bit hard because I was at home, not able to do anything, and it was so hard. It's hard to come back. But Mark would come back. He continued to ski within authorized limits. His challenge was to be able to ski with more strength and with less effort. I have to be careful about my workload. I have to go a little more smoothly. For example, if the others are doing a series of something four or five times, for me, it'll be three or four. If they do 2 hours of skiing, for me, 1 hour 30, and so on. If I need 2 or 3 days of rest, well, I have to take them. It's what my body needs. His worst enemy is the sun, and Mark is taking no risks. He waited for the medical authorization before committing finally to these university games. I had some tests 1 month before coming here, and I had the results 2 weeks after that. The analyses came out really well. There were two or three things that weren't so good, but it was just a week before coming here that they said, you can go. So we decided to come. For Mark, the Universiade was a new lease of life. When I'm at the start, I don't know why, but I believe that I unplug a little bit more than last year. I don't know why it's like that, but I feel more relaxed. I think I'm more spontaneous as well. I have no benchmark for this competition at all. I came out really aggressively. I felt strong. And I thought to myself, okay, I'm going to give this everything I can. And the feeling was really good. Well, I made two or three mistakes. There was a turn where I slipped and touched a gate, but it didn't stop me from continuing the race. And getting down towards the bottom, I made a big mistake on the jump. And in my head, I said to myself, uh-oh, either you're totally out of control, and that's why you've made mistakes, or you're really, really fast, and that's why you've made mistakes. And that was it. And at the finish, I knew I was fast. And when I saw my time, I was so happy. Very surprised, too. And after that, when the race is over, you say, damn it, yeah, that's really good. This is the first medal. You've come back, you could say, from injury. And for me, it really was really good. A moment of joy. Yeah. Mark missed the gold by 1/100 of a second. But the records will show that he won his country's first medal in the Winter Universiades. And quite a story it was. At the University Games, two female Olympic champions were in the lineup. One from the parallel slalom, the other from the parallel giant slalom. Two friends and rivals about to go head-to-head once more. It was just the same at the last Universiade. There's always a high standard with the World Cup competitors at the start. But it's really fun, and getting a medal here means so much, you know. It's a lot of fun to compete against each other. You know that you have to push hard. Of course, it's something quite special that we like to practice and compete together. And we appreciate each other a lot. The competition was held in the Sierra Nevada with a snowpark that features the longest course in Europe. But how different is it from Monte Bondone, where the last Universiade was held at Trentino in Italy? Maybe this time it'll be a little bit more technical. Last time the visibility was bad, I remember. We couldn't take many risks. I think this time it's on a large hill, so I don't know whether we'll have to make tight turns or not. Of course, you can't tell beforehand. But I think I can manage the races all right. The two athletes here may be rivals, but the rivalry is good-natured, and they're used to competing against each other. Yeah, we've known each other for a long time. We're the same age. We've competed together in so many races, and it's really enjoyable. She's such a good person, too. And speaking with her during competitions is really interesting. Now Patrizia Kummer is ready for the final. I really love the feeling just before the race. I'm ready for the competition. I think it's going to be great fun, and I'll approach it like every other competition, going flat out to be with the best. Unfortunately, no Julia Dzumowicz. She's been disqualified in the first round, but now Patrizia Kummer will race to victory, beating Germany's Selina Jörg and Nadia Ochner of Italy. Kummer taking the Universiade title at the third attempt. I'm mega happy. I can't believe it, really, because I've competed twice before. First I was seventh, then fourth. So I said to myself, it's always like minus three, and that means next time I can win it. And it happened. I'm so glad. Patrizia Kummer, now the queen of the Olympic and the University Games. Still to come on Campus Sport, the man who almost quit and was glad he didn't. And the happy underdogs of ice hockey in just a moment.
Education meets sport and culture. What best promotes excellence in mind and body? Where do friendship, integrity, and achievement meet? Which event gathers the best student athletes from around the world? The Universiade, the home of international university sports. Today's stars, tomorrow's leaders.